regarding distance, displacement, speed and velocity. And you're going to learn about average speed, average velocity and uniform motion and non-uniform motion. Okay, so first, what is speed? So speed, we have learned that it is nothing but the distance traveled by time taken. Yes, sir. Means in unit time, how much distance you are covering, that determines your speed. Okay, and here on the average speed, what can we say that? Now, if you are taking the whole journey, now think that you are moving from your house to school. Then, if you are riding on a bicycle, then first, what will be your speed before riding the bicycle? It will be zero. And initially, it will be somewhat increasing. Again, later on, if it is a plain road and if any no traffic is there, then what happens, your speed will be increased. Again, if any traffic is there, then again the speed decreases. Again, after reaching there, then you slowly slow down your bicycle. So, you can see the difference in the speeds in different situations, but on the same journey, right? So, this is the average speed. So, by calculating total distance covered by the total time taken, we can determine the average speed. Okay, so let us take your total distance was some 2 kilometers and the time taken was half an hour. Okay, so here that the total distance is 2 kilometers per half an hour. Means for 1 hour, how much kilometers you can run? That is 4 kilometers per hour. So your average speed was nothing but 4 kilometers per hour. Okay, so I hope you have understood the... So, let us understand average speed practically. So, this is a point A and that is a point B. And I can follow any path and this is the point B. So, let me take this long path. And this is the point B. Okay. So, here I was traveling through this all distance. And initially when I am here, my speed was zero. And when I started walking, my speed gradually increased. When I am walking here, again it got increased. Again. So again I have reached here. So there is a variation in the speeds. Yes or no? So initially it was 0 meters per second. Let me take the arrow. Covered the 10 meters of distance. And initially my speed was 0 meters per second. Again it has increased to 2 meters per second. Next to 4 meters per second. Again 1 meters per second. So, isn't it there is a variation in the speed? Yes, there is a variation in the speed. So, here, if we are calculating the total distance by total time taken, then we will be getting the average speed. So, the total distance covered by me is 10 meters. And the total time taken was here 0 plus 2 plus 4 and here 1. So, how much totally it is? Total 6 seconds. So, 10 meters per 6 seconds is my average speed. Okay, now what is average velocity? So, velocity we know that it is rate of change of displacement. So, displacement is the shortest distance covered. So, obviously the shortest distance will be the straight line path. Okay, so this is the point A and point B. Now, I am starting walking to the point B. Okay, so this will be my velocity. Okay, I am walking in certain direction. Here I did not follow any direction. I was moving in different directions and I have reached the point B. But here I am following a unidirection and I am reaching the point B. And the speed we can take that again there is a variation in the velocities. Here initial velocity was 0. Again the velocity has increased. So let me take that for covering this 6 meters of distance. I have taken 3 seconds. Then what will be my average velocity? Total displacement by total time taken. That is 6 meters by 3 seconds. So on the whole average velocity was 2 meters per second towards right side. So hope you all have understood what is average speed and average velocity. Now let us understand uniform motion and non-uniform motion. So let us take the same distance again. So in the uniform motion, the distance covered and the time taken will be same. Okay, so the same 6 meters of distance. So for 1 second, let me take 1 step. And for another second, another step. Again third, one more step. One more. Okay. So for each second, I am moving one step forward. Okay, so like that we can take that this is a uniform motion. Then what will be the non-uniform? So non-uniform motion. So non-uniform motion is for each time taken, the distance covered will be varied. So in the previous, in the uniform motion, what did we see? For each second, I was covering one step forward. But in the non-uniform motion, it won't be like that. So for 1 second, here I have taken one step. And for another second, I am taking two steps. And for another second, I am taking three steps. So is it my motion stable? No, it is not stable. For each second, the distance covered is changing. Initially, I have taken one step, then two steps, then three steps. Okay, the distance covered will be same. But the motion covered or the way I have walked, that will be generally. So generally, whatever movements we see in our regular intervals, that is in our real life, we all see this non-uniform motion. So let us take an example of a train. So initially, the train will be at rest. Means the uniform motion. It is not moving. Yes. So it is zero. Again, slowly it will start moving. Then slowly the speed will be increasing. The distance covered by this time taken will be varying. Again, it will be moving very fast. Okay, so the speed is changing and the distance covered by the same time will be different. Right? So like that, again while coming to the rest, then what happens? Again, it slows down. Again, it stops. So there will be variation in the speed. So that is what the non-uniform motion. Then, so I hope you have understood all these four characteristics, that is average speed, average velocity and uniform motion and non-uniform motion. If you have any doubt in this regarding this topic, you can comment me in my comment section. And before that, you need to comment one more thing also. Then where do we observe uniform motion? So give any two examples and comment me in my comment section. Until then, keep observing and keep learning. Thank you.